Creating a boundary scan test project just became even easier and quicker. Firstly, XJTAG's latest software release, XJTAG 3.13, gives you an efficient way to deal with product variants. Secondly, it introduces a new algorithm that aims to automatically detect I2C devices and set up their test device files for you. Next, you'll discover that categorization of power and ground nets is simpler. And if you're using XJE's dialog boxes, you'll find you can now include images. Let me run through those in turn. Think about products that have build variants. For instance, you might have a board that accepts two different memory sizes, or one that has the option to fit additional features. With XJTAG 3.13, those kinds of projects are easy to manage. You now only need to create one baseline project and then define how each variant differs from it. There's a new wizard you can use if each variant has its own BOM file. It compares the BOM to the baseline project and makes proposals on which devices have changed and how to categorize them. If you don't have separate BOM files, you can define the variations manually instead. This new software release makes your work setting up build variants quicker and more efficient. And once they're set up and you come to run board tests, you can either select which variant is being tested from a menu at runtime, or you can produce individual XJPack files, one for each variant. Another benefit of XJTAG 3.13 will be obvious when you categorize I2C devices. XJ Developer comes with a new algorithm that aims to automatically detect when an IC you're categorizing has an I2C interface. When it finds one, all the basic aspects of setting up I2C devices that used to be done manually can now be performed automatically. The algorithm detects an I2C device by inspecting the names of the nets connected to it, looking for one containing the text SDA and another containing SCL. As well as that, if you've already categorized an I2C device, XJ Developer will look for connections to that device's bus. When it recognizes that the device uses I2C, you'll be offered the option of allowing XJ Developer to create a basic test automatically for that device, if one isn't already in the library. The resulting test will check that the device acknowledges its address, and you can then build on that basic test if you want to. You would add device-specific tests by copying code from a related library file or by reference to its datasheet. Another change you'll notice when you create a project in XJTAG 3.13 is evident when you categorize power and ground nets. It's an enhancement that makes XJ Developer's proposals clearer by presenting the results from its analysis differently. Rather than grouping the power and ground nets by the methods it uses to find them, a combined list is now presented where each suggestion is accompanied by a score that shows the degree of confidence in that suggestion. The stated figure is calculated based on several factors. It examines the net's name, the number of capacitors connected to the net, and what other devices are connected to it. For example, the presence of what could be pull resistors or inductors will increase the net score. So, when you come to categorize the nets, those scores make it easy to find which ones truly are power and to avoid accidentally categorizing signals like 3v3 Pgood. It makes the checking process quicker and simpler. Now let's move on from categorizing and think about XJE's dialogues. You might use one to instruct an operator to fit a loopback connector before a particular test runs, for instance. XJTAG 3.13 now allows you to add images to your message boxes and input boxes. All the main image types are supported. That's JPEG, PNG, bitmap, TIFF, and GIF, including animated GIFs. As an example, you could use it to add clarity to your instructions by including a photograph that shows what the board looks like with connectors or jumpers in place. So, all in all, we think you'll get real benefits from this new release of XJTAG's boundary scan software. If your product has build variants or uses I2C devices, setting up the test project is now even faster than before. Categorizing power and ground nets is now more efficient, and the message text you put in dialog boxes can now be enhanced by adding images. If you've got a valid support contract, you can download XJTAG 313 from our website. Otherwise, contact us at inquiries@xjtag.com or find out more by visiting xjtag.com.